Yeah. Hello. Good afternoon. And welcome to this week's Viewer's Volition, Viewer's Choice this week. It was a tight race. It was a tight race between that's interesting that shows up. It was a tight race between Stellaris and Universal Combat. I chose Universal Combat because someone asked if I would play Battlecruiser 3000 AD. I'm not sure I can get that running on today's hardware. So I figured this is the new version of Universal Combat from Steam with the Lyrius Conflict DLC, and that apparently includes the scenarios from Battlecruiser. I gotta say, I was out sick today, you guys. I feel like crap. I did not sleep for some reason last night, and when I did, I had the craziest dreams. So I am loopy right now. Loopy! And I'm not even drunk. I'm just tired. A little loopy. So I have played this before. It's been a while, but I have played this before. Can you guys see? Oh my god. It's weird. Some games. Some games, like when you have the game capture thing on OBS, they won't capture the Steam overlay, but this one will. So, if you haven't played Universal Combat. If you haven't played Universal Combat, it's a heck of a thing. It's a spaceship fighter, ground combat. It's all over the place. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you a few things. I'm gonna show you the tutorial first off. Okay, and we're gonna do the tutorial. Now this is the roam part of the game where you can basically just do what you want. You can kind of just roam the universe. It's a fairly big universe. There are several dozen systems, if I recall correctly. All right, so this scenario, there we go. Wants us to go to Alpha Centauri. Oh, it's so loud. That's weird. Anyway, I turned down the volume on the game, and it still sounds really loud to me. If it sounds too loud to you, just let me know. All right, so let's see. We are supposed to. Let's see. So. All right, so basically, we are to go to engage. We're to engage and destroy ships in the Nuvela, in the Alpha Centauri area. Now, this game has a tutorial, and the tutorial has a 93-page manual, or 97-page manual that's longer than the game's 90-some page manual. So I skimmed it. I mean, I've played this before, but I skimmed it because I didn't have time to read the whole thing. If you do have time to read the whole thing, this is the kind of game for you because this is detailed stuff. So let's see. So we went ahead there. And so I'm giving my command ship. Yeah, the game is muffled, Dan. That's just how the game sounds. I'm giving my command ship. The command to fly this gate. Whoa! Now, I believe we also have. Yeah, we also have. Two ships. that are with us that we can give orders to. We also have 4 fighters and 2 shuttles. Yeah, it's supposed to sound like a bridge, like it's muffled. It's kind of the point. It's kind of the point. So now we just wait. How far are we? This is TAC Ops. This is a screen where you could see the entire sector that you're in. Zoom into things. So, there's us. So you can give orders from the screen, which is nice. You can also pause the game, and I believe also, oh, you can't give orders. You can't give orders while the game is paused. Oh well. Let's go back to the bridge. Oh, there's the range right there. I haven't played this in a while, so I'm a little rusty. So apparently our ships are escorting me. Okay. Alright. There's the gate. So make sure I did this right. No, I want to go there. Alright, so now the autopilot is gonna eventually dock me with that jump gate. We just have to wait a minute. Oh, thank you, Dan, for watching the Roland MT-32 video. Yeah, you know what? I didn't either. I didn't know idea Star Control sound that good until I ran it last night to test it. I was like, oh my god, it sounds amazing. Holy crap, this little piece of hardware. Like, I don't know if you remember, but back in the late 80s and early 90s, you had to be like a whiz kid or rich or something to have one of these things, these M32s here. So I feel really lucky to have one because it feels like authentic, you know? Okay. Okay. Hit pause. I can't pause from here? Okay. So you see we have a couple of ships. We have a couple of bad guys in the sector. We have a bad guy station and a bad guy ship. A couple of bad guy ships. All right. So I'm going to tell my... let's take a look here real quick. Activating. What? Okay. So hang on. Okay. Target Oath 2? I don't know. I'm going to tell to attack enemy. I'm going to tell my ship to target O2. And so now we are going to hit the hyperdrive and fly over to this bad guy. Yeah, that guy. And once we get near there, I'm going to have my fighters launch and do some escorting. So let's see. What? Okay. Ah. Okay. Let's turn on the turrets. Activated. Yeah, I think we have to wait for the hyperdrive to charge up before we can hit it again. But once... There it goes. Boom. So now what I'm doing, the ship has a bunch of missiles as well. So I'm designating that these missiles shoot at this one particular target. Once I get there, it's gonna take a moment for me to get there. As you can see, we're interesting. So the thing about Battlecruiser 3000 and its ilk is that it's got lots of different systems you can fiddle with. Like, for example, this is the tactical system. I could see where the crew is and I could change their assignment. I could launch fighters or shuttles. I forget what OC is, honestly. I could see the loadout of the fighters, the shuttles, the command craft, missiles, mines, probes. So I could load all these if I want to. You can see who's in the meta bay. You can take a look at your fighters. You can take a look at your cargo. You can fiddle with your power. I just looked at that one. This is clearly the map that we were just looking at. You could, you can go to every place in here. So it's quite a bit to see and do. And then we have, you know, that's me. It's our officers. Take a look at our Marines who don't have names. This is the mission computer that tells us what our current mission is. This is our comm link that gives us a log of I guess target 2 left. So we're just going to have this guy target 3 now. Maybe he surrendered? Because he was red, now he's yellow? That's weird. That's really weird. Huh. What's going on? Oh, I think there's a battle already going on that I can hear. Whoa, hey. Oh, target 2 is red. Whoa, that's pretty cool. So I'm going to have my fighters launch. We're going to escort. And we are going to turn off the autopilot. You can totally fly by yourself if you want, kind of like a fighter. Whoa! All right. Well then. Oh. Crazy. So who's left? Shuttle. Alright, time to kill the station. Attack. Enemy. Let's kill the station. If I tell my command craft to also attack the station, that's what it's going to do. So, let's go. Have the autopilot at least get us there. Oh. And we're not too far away. See, there goes the Avalon. And really, those ships did not stand up to the might of this fully armed and operational carrier. I think that's what this is, a carrier. I totally forget the keys. Hang on. I couldn't find a quick reference. I couldn't find when I looked earlier. There it is. Keyboard command sheet. One was listed on Steam, but that wasn't the right one. Hi. Online? I'm looking for a PDF. Oh, there's the station. I guess I'm gonna wing it. Cause I don't have time to read this whole manual here. 90 pages. Alright, let's turn the autopilot off. Can we hit it from here? Alright. Let's start shooting missiles at it. Bonk a donk a donk 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 donk. What does that mean? This game looks like black coffee with dry toast. Can I hit it yet? Nope, still too far, I guess. Interesting how it doesn't seem to respond. Oh, it does respond to my throttle, just very little, very teeny bit. Yeah, I'm too far. Oh. Alright, so Windstar, I need you to also attack the station. Wait, what? It turned yellow. What does that mean exactly? It turned yellow. I still want to blow it up. Did they surrender? I mean, what does that mean? Does that mean I did it? I mean, we killed two other ships. So there are no enemies now in this sector. Hostile insurgent ships. Engage and destroy the hostile insurgent ships. Whoops, okay. I'm gonna blow up the station anyway because I feel like it. Oh, look at that. Interesting. So it's interesting. I looked up like a keyboard command. You know, I looked up a keyboard command, like just a sheet. You know, and the first listing is a forum on their is a forum thread on their forum saying, "Hey, can I have a keyboard command sheet? I lost mine." And everyone's like, "You pirated the game. We're not going to give you one. Go buy it." That's a bit hostile, don't you think? Like, I can't find one. And I own multiple copies of this game on disc and digitally. I bought two copies of the original Battlecruiser 3000 AD when it came out. So, yeah. I am using a joystick, Joel. I am using my Microsoft Sidewinder Force Feedback 2 stick, which works pretty well. Can I hit it from here yet? Apparently not. How close do I got to be to hit it? With my big ass guns. Shoot it. Can I designate that a target? Hang on. Attack it. Hey, fighters, go attack it. Yeah, Joel, if you go to the About page of the channel here, I have all my hardware listed, my throttle, my pedals, my stick, all that stuff. So you can totally see easily what I've got in terms of hardware. But it's all right there because I get that question quite often, actually. Any mail?
No, just junk.
Okay. Still can't hit it yet. I want to kill it and then move on to the next thing. The next thing is we're going to land on a planet, or at least we're going to try to. I haven't done that in a while. Or we can just start a new career as a planet guy. We will try both. You can't hear the sound? I'm still getting that sound is going through OBS. No, I'm not using push to talk. Ah! No push to talk right now. I don't think so. No, I got no push to talk. Oh, missiles are going. Oh. Alright. They're hitting the shields. Oh, there go shields. Let's see, I know there's a way to give. Oh, okay, and shields are down. I guess I'm not close enough to actually hit it yet. Oh, that's adorable. That's so cute. Tell my turrets to shoot at something. I totally forget. Well, hang on. Let's see what this does. Oh, autopilot. What are you doing? Oh, it's so cute. Oh, station's about to go bye-bye. Oh, ow. Boom, boom. Boomity boom. Boom. Whoa, what? Okay, I guess that's debris. That just came out of nowhere, didn't it? All right. Okay, I need you guys to turn to base. Turn to base. All right. okay, now, let's take a look at the map here. No, that's a ship. Okay. That's a moon. That's also... There's no planets here? Oh, there is a planet. There's a planet. There's a planet. Okay. Alright, so let's see. Command craft orders. Fly to planet. Bonk. We're gonna fly the planet, and then I'm gonna take a fighter down. I haven't done that in a while. To the surface. Because, yeah, that's one of the selling points of these games. Is you could fly over planets. It's one of the first, if not, I think, the first game to do that. So, you know, good on Derek Smart, who might be watching you guys. He said on Facebook he's going to this. So, hi Derek, if you're here. Legendary Derek Smart. Okay, I'm wondering if the autopilot's going to fly me into the planet. Or is just going to put me in orbit of it. Let's see what happens. Get a little close there, autopilot. I think I gave you the order to fly to, not into. Oh, jeez. Hey, autopilot. Hey, autopilot. Oh, there's my fighter. Oh, the interceptor's docked. All right. So we're going to launch Interceptor 3. And I how do I do it? I know there's a way to switch to it, I just can't freaking remember what it is. Yeah, I know. Okay, forget it. Oh, wait. Interesting. Okay, well, yeah. Yeah. So you saw some of that. Now let's, that's what it is. Oh, hang on. Oh. All right, so let's try one of these things. These on. I'm so out of it, you guys. Seriously. Alright, let's see. So these are advanced campaign missions. And these will put you in the role of a commander or a pilot. Huh. So let's try this one. Now we're going to be a fighter pilot, which I have a lot less experience with in this game, but that's something you can do. Nothing yet. Ah, it's loud. First strikes. Okay, well, I don't have any orders yet. That's kind of funny how it's like it knows it's missing things. Whoa, whoa, whoa. What the what? Okay. Okay, what am I doing? What do you need me to do, guys? Huh. Okay, I've got no orders. I'm stuck in VTOL mode. I don't. This doesn't help me. See, now you'd think, quick reference. When I load that, I'm thinking, hey, that's, you know, the keyboard guide. Nope, that's a 97-page tutorial PDF, you guys. Who's got time for that? I don't. I wish it would just list the keys somewhere. But they're just all over the place, spread across the manual. I'm not sure what I'm supposed to be doing here. I don't have any. Let's see. Urgent. Oh, did I get an urgent message? Jeez, finally. Okay. Okay. Let's see. Oh. But there's nothing, there's nothing at all. There are no bad guys in the, don't know what I'm supposed to do with that. Let's try a Marine. Yeah, you could be a Marine. I just wanted to land on a planet, you guys. That's all I wanted to do. All right. Well, whoa. What? Oh, man. Okay, so now we're on a planet. What the? Where? So I wonder which button fires the gun.
Urgent message received.
Oh, hey. Okay. Just tell me where to go, sir. So, the neat thing about this is the mouse axes are reversed. Oh, what's going on over there? Something's going on over here, and I want to find out what. Whoa. Well, they're the bad guys. A pair of the mouse moves you forward. The right mouse key. I would shoot you if I knew how. Ah. Hi, guys. Okay. That wasn't me. Okay, that shoots if I switch, Okay, that works. Okay, well. So weird. Oh, interesting. Oh, hey, this is neat. I'm on a planet that earlier I could have flown above in my... Whoa. What is that? Is that a ship? Can I steal it? I don't know what LF and FF mean, but they're probably not good. Unless when FF goes down to nothing, I might die. But I want to see what that is. Is that a ship? Can I take it? Hey, what? Okay. Is that the thing shooting at me? You know, honey, I'm doing some very important streaming here, and...
Sorry, I have to do this tonight.
I know, I'm kidding. It's not that important. I think I'm about to die, you guys. I can't run anymore. Can I jump? Nope, can't jump either. What was that other rifle? I could, like, jump with this thing. What is happening here? Okay. Yeah. We're just gonna be a commander, cause that's what I'm used to. So we got a world apart. Huh? Fragile hope. Nah. Nah. Yeah, this one looks fun. Enjoying my Snapple. I didn't want to drink coffee today because I wanted to be able to actually sleep tonight. And so I'm drinking something with just a tiny bit of caffeine in it, like Snapple. Hi, kitty. No, you can't come up. No, not right now. There's no room for you on the bridge, kitty. Okay. Back on the bridge, which is where we belong, really.
Message received.
There we go. Let's see. So I'm gonna escort a diplomat ship. Okay. Has it launched yet? Doesn't look like it. Yeah, not there yet. Okay. So lower the throttle all the way to the bottom. There's Galcom. There it is. Alright, so Diplomat 1 will be leaving Galcom. Excuse me. Yeah, and then I'm gonna escort the ship. Just gotta wait for it to launch, I guess. That looks like a satellite of some type. Alright, let's see.
Activating TAC off computer.
Come on, let me zoom in a little more. You're not gonna let me zoom in some more? Ah. Alright. Escort, friendly, escort. Diplomat 1.
Hyperdrive activated.
There's Diplomat 1. Escort. Other Diplomat 1. Whoops. Not what I meant.
Activating TAC off computer.
Oh, there's Diplomat 1. We should be able, there you are. There's Diplomat 1. Okay, we are supposed to escort Diplomat 1. Incoming transmission from Diplomat 1. Okay. There isn't. Oh, I guess the glad to see you command. I guess the glad to see you commander. Alright, so we're gonna escort that guy.
Emerging from hyperspace.
Let's launch two fighters to escort. Okay, orders, escort, other. Gonna give them orders to also escort diplomat one. Alright. So now we're just gonna escort diplomat one there. And follow them wherever they go. I will follow you. Follow you wherever you may go. Wow, that's terrible. That was... Yeah, don't let me do that again. Why did you let me do that, guys? Don't let me ever do that again. Hey, wait a minute. Where are you going? Wait for us. We should all jump together. Don't go yet. Don't go. Or is it just always like that? You know what? I don't mind them if they're like kind of Star Trek-y. Like, oh, we have a diplomat to escort. I don't mind. It's when you're in a little fighter, you know, and you have to escort like a freighter. It's like 18 fighters against your two little escort. Like, great. So, it depends. It depends. Okay, so they jumped. So now I guess we're going to jump. I hope. You know, someone could be waiting at the other end of that gate for them and then just blow them up while we're just... Oh, it almost starts humming the... Starflight theme. All right. Okay, so far so good. I can't whistle that low. Now the game's still running. Why? No. Okay, where are my fighters? They're taking up position. Yes, they are. Good. Good. And they've got the right orders. Good. That's exactly what they should be doing. Who is that? Oh. Satellite type thing. What's this? What's this? Oh. Yeah, see, that's exactly what I was thinking of. Like, someone could just be sitting on this other side of that gate waiting for Diplomat 1 here, which is a very creative name, by the way, to just slide on through. Give us your money or we'll blow you up. You know, and in the 10 minutes it took between me getting to the gate, you know, they could have blowed up. Oh, great. Did they just hit the hyperdrive? Yeah, they did. Could you wait until my hyperdrive is charged up? Can we all stick together? Could we do that? Can we just stick together? I mean, doesn't that make sense? I know you have, like, your orders, but, I mean, doesn't it make sense that we all jump when we all stick together, you know, so we can shield you, we could protect you. That's what we're here to, hug you and protect you. But we can't if you be like, hey, I'm going to go now. Wait, no. Okay. We'll catch up. Don't die. Please. Just don't die. Just don't die. I will admit, this game does get something, something's right. It does feel like you're in charge of a starship, which a lot of games don't get right. And I wish games like Rules of Engagement would be less combat-focused and more, oh, go explore this, oh, go do that. Because that would be great. I want more of that in my life. I want to... As much as I love the action and the battle, I also would love the mundane, oh, we have to scan sector something for a scientific mission. That'd be cool. I would do that. Because I'd feel like, you know, this is what Starfleet does. But now it's all combat, 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 combat. Shooty, shooty, shooty. What's that? Okay, wait, can you not jump yet until we're right, like, with you? Could you, like, hang tight? No, you're just going to go, aren't you? Okay. Okay. Can I put... Hang on. No, that's not it. It's this. Can I put more power to the hyperdrive? Like, I don't need turrets right now. Oh. So I'd like to put more power to the engine. Oh, okay. Now, is that also the hyperdrive? I think Rogue System is going to be quite a bit of combat because you're fighting for, I think, the independence of a system. So I think it's going to be like the Falcon 4, like combat. No Man's Sky, I'm still not sold on. I'm still not sold on that. One game that got it right besides Starflight, Nomad. If you ever played Nomad from 1993 from Game Tech, that game got exploration and discovery right, where you're not just shooting things, you're trading, you're exploring, you're doing missions. It just felt great. I miss games like that. Okay, so let's turn off okay, so we put all power to engines. I'm hoping that lets our hyperdrive charge a little faster.
Laser turret is offline.
Why? I didn't take power away from the turrets. So why is the turret offline? There's still some power units available. I don't know. We're going through a wormhole, you guys. Woohoo! Yeah, Dan, Rogue System's going to be great for the pushy buttony thing. I'm really excited about that. The new version that just hit Steam is nice. It's basically just a flight model with a bunch of buttons, but wow, it's so great. It terrifies me. Yeah, see, Shaw, that's what I was about to say. It terrifies me when something can go wrong. What we got? Oh, okay. When something goes wrong, one thing in your ship can get damaged, and all of a sudden you don't have your left engine. It's like, ah! Apparently that's exactly what he's going for. We're going to try and have him back on the podcast in the next month or so. That'll be his third time back, so hopefully we can arrange that, because he was our very first guest 3-some years ago. And we've kept in touch. Mike is a great guy, so I'm just tickled that his game, even after a failed Kickstarter, is on Steam. It's getting good reviews. Yeah, I'm tickled about that. So I am tickled about Rogue System. Oh, is he going to hyperspace? Yeah, there he goes. God damn it, I can't get... you mother forker. Okay. Have fun storming the castle. We'll get there when we get there. Hopefully there's nothing bad there. I just want to see what happens. I just want to see if anything happens. Yeah, apparently, eventually with EVA, Shaw, in Rogue System, you'll also be able to go over to other ships and take them over as well. That's the plan. Do you mean the follow-up to Evercron Legacy? Like, what do you mean? Because Evercron Legacy does have exploration. It just doesn't feel as explorate-y. Like, you can jump in between sectors and, like, find random stuff, which, like, planets that weren't supposed to be there. That's kind of cool. But Evercrown Legacy is great. If you guys haven't played it, Evercrown Legacy is great. Odyssey, which game are you asking about? Are you asking about Rogue System? Like, you've heard great things about this game, which... If you're asking about Rogue System, yes, it's fantastic. Still very early access, so there's really no gameplay there just yet. It's basically a flight model with some buttons, but wow. If you're asking about Evercrown Legacy, Evercrown Legacy is fan-goddamn-tastic. If you're asking about this... Oh, this. This is, this is, Universal Combat. This is Universal Combat, which is the latest iteration of the Battlecruiser 3000 line of games. I don't even remember the Princess Bride quote I made. I just love that movie. All of our conference rooms at my job are named after Princess Bride characters. So we have Roberts, Vizzini, Fezzik, Montoya. It's pretty great. Diplomat, can you wait? Just hang tight. Can you wait for me? Why can't I send you a message? Oh, shit. I almost spilled my drink. Odyssey, it depends on who you talk to. I know a lot of people who dislike this game. I think it's great for what it tries to do. Yeah, Helmet, Mercenary, Legacy, Evercrown Legacy is the latest Evercrown game, and it is old school in how it flies. It's definitely more for the hardcore. That's why the tutorial for it is 2.5 hours long, fully interactive. What? What? Where? Wait. What? I don't see... Wait a minute. What the hell's going on? What the hell? What the hell? What the hell's going on? Why do I hear gun? What the hell is going on? I hear gunfire. Well, it sounds like gunfire, but I... But I don't see anything. I don't see anything. So we're over here. What the what? What the hell? Okay, I'm very confused. Because Odyssey, I drank and flew 2 weeks ago. I'm not doing that again. That was embarrassing. Okay, so now we're catching up with Diplomat. I'm not sure what's going on. I see no enemies on the scope. Our target looks fine. I mean, there's also no sound in space, but... I'm really not sure what's happening. Excuse me. Yeah, it sounds like a pitched battle is going on somewhere. Somewhere. But I can't see... Yeah, these guys look fine. I'm really confused, so... So I'm hearing a battle. This is the weirdest thing. Like, if there was a battle on the other side of the jump gate, you wouldn't think I'd be able to hear it. Yeah, we got our fighters. We got a couple of, what look like stations. Oh, there's stations. And then we got our diplomat here, who isn't damaged in the slightest. Huh? Who's that? What, who? Okay. I guess there's a fight going on somewhere. Maybe I just can't see it. Maybe it's like behind the moon, but then why could I hear it? That's weird. I am so confused right now, you guys. And there goes my guy. There goes my guy. Or girl. Not sure. Oh, now we got bad guys. Crap. Hang on, what do we got? What do we got? What do we got? What do we got? Okay, we got two fighters. Okay. Attack. Enemy. Oh, crap. Attack. Attack the fighter. Where is the fighter?
We have intruders on board.
We do? We have intruders on board. Where'd they come from? We have one intruder, apparently, in the fitness center. Our Marines are looking for him, though. Alright, how's our boy doing? He's fine. He's not close enough to do anything. What are you doing? Okay, we're gonna have you escort me. No, no, no. Escort. No, no, no. Escort. How can we tell you to escort me? I guess we can't. I want you to escort me, goddammit. Someone's playing. Someone on the bridge playing. Spaces. That man over there is playing Galaga. We didn't think he didn't think we'd notice, but we did. Wow. So I can't tell my fighters. Are you guys after the Star Cruiser? Where's Diplomat 1? Now, fighters, I told you to escort.
Marines are engaging combat on the subdeck.
Wait, what? Apparently the guy is still in the fitness center. But he's hurting. How are our fighters doing? Damn, we got all our fighters attacking a Star Cruiser. That's from the Avengers, Dan. Is this guy even being hurt? Not really. Okay, guys, I need you guys to escort Diplomat. If you're not going to escort me, at least escort that guy. That's one of my favorite parts of the Avengers, by the way, is that that guy was actually playing Galaga. I mean, do you really need that machine to play Galaga anymore? I don't know. But, okay, so our fighters are now escorting the Diplomat, which is what they should have been doing all along. I don't like letting that Star Carrier that Star Cruiser go, but at the same time we have a job to do, so we're just gonna see if we can get this guy to his destination. Why are two people telling me I'm approaching the wormhole? Oh, what's that? Okay, it's an enemy station. Okay, fighters, what are you doing? No, guys. Oh my god. Guys. Just, please. Do what I'm telling you to do. Don't worry about Templon. Really? Templon?
Activating TAC off the computer.
What's a Templon? That looks like a fighter of some type. What are you guys doing? Okay, good. Stay with the Diplomat. Stay with the Diplomat. Jeez. That's what we're supposed to be doing here. Well, Diplomat 2, Doc, that's part of the mission, right? Right? Fighters, what are you doing? Okay.
Recruiting
So yeah, once the diplomat docks, I think our mission's done. At least this one. There might be other missions after this one, but yeah. Not seeing any other. Yeah, I'm not seeing any other fighters. Just the station here. There goes Lydia. Okay, the fighters seem to be doing their jobs. Weren't there Final Fantasy-esque games in space, like Space Rogue or Star Rogue or whatever the hell that was, and a couple others? There's a game on the DS called Infinite Space that I've been playing that some people tell me is like Final Fantasy. Do we got any incoming? No, these guys aren't bothering us. Okay, that's good. This would be a good game to listen to podcasts to with this sort of mission. As long as you turn the volume up, because this is loud. And I think in the game options, I have the Infinite Space is great, Eric, but it's also very difficult. Like, I'm stuck. And I hate walkthroughs. I hate having to rely on walkthroughs, but I'm stuck in, like, the second system. I can't find any work. Odyssey, the background noise is from the game. It's intentional. It's meant to make you feel like you're on the bridge. So that is from the game itself. And again, is intentional. Are we like... Okay. I guess we're waiting for them to jump. All right, the diplomat and the fighters just jumped. Now it's our turn. Why we can't just all jump together? It's a pretty big wormhole. I don't know. It's a pretty big jump kit, I mean. I don't know, whatever. Oh. What do we got? Guys, Jesus, guys, do I have to give you this damn mission every time? Hang on, stop it. Guys, escort, Jesus. No, don't, not escort Jesus. Oh, that's great. What? You've got to be kidding me. So. Yeah. So, here's what happened. I gave my fighters standing escort orders to escort. Thank you. I gave my fighters orders to escort Diplomat 1. Okay? As soon as they jump into this new system, they're like, hey, there's an enemy. Let's go shoot it. Like, guys, no, I told you to do this other thing. They all just got blown up. I just lost all four of my fighters because they couldn't listen to orders. Really? You guys? Really? I mean, I told you to do this thing. Personnel with high fatigue. Who's got high fatigue? I guess some of the I don't know what any of these mean. I guess they got that intruder guy. So I guess these guys have off. These guys are off duty, I guess. What was that? What was that? Yeah, apparently they just forget after every jump what I told them to do the last jump. Every time. And now they're all dead. That's great. I've lost all of them. All my fighters, all my support, all my support. I've got shuttles, but yeah, they're not really armed. Yeah, we're going to do one little more little thingy thing thing, and then we're just going to stop. Yeah, send the shuttles. No! All right, let's choose another one. Guys, I'm laughing because Eric in the chat said they'll never get over Macho Grande. You have to decide. You have to decide. Oh, I want to watch that now. Shit. I want to watch that so bad now. Ooh, Strike Fleet. I'll do it. I'll take the case. This is the last thing I'm doing. Oh, gosh. Why, fighter pilots? Ooh, new battle cruiser thingy-majiggy. I have fleet command and control. Ooh. So I've got... That's a station, but I've also got... Yeah, okay. Okay, now I guess we gotta wait a second before our orders come in. I can't just give them to you. Right. So, yeah, we got four interceptors, four shuttles. Wait, what? Why do I no longer have fleet command and control? I thought that was the point! Yeah, I'm the battle group leader, and I've been assigned a carrier strike fleet. Okay. Okay. Oh, urgent message. Zippity doodah. June system. Okay. That's right, Hussy. Battle group leader? This fucking guy? He just lost four fighters. I didn't lose. Hey, he just lost four fighters. No, it wasn't my fault. He just lost four fighters. God. Fine. All right, so where are we going? June system. June. June. Okay, so let's see. Navcon. Navitron. Janae, where's Janae? Janae. How the hell is that? Where is it? There's Midday. Jupiter. Wow. When I move this, it in OBS it looks all flickery. Where am I going? There's no like search functionality or anything. Hang on. No, I haven't been assigned Dick. J-U-N-A-E, okay? Where the hell? How the hell? J-U-N-A-E. How the hell is it? Go away. Where is it? Did I miss it somehow? Yeah, right. Hey, hey, new guy. Hey, you, yeah. We need you to go over to Janae. You know, Janae. That's right. It's all the way over there on the other side of Omega Centauri. Yeah, you can't miss it. Just go over there. Yeah. Go fight the things over there. Yes, it'll be great. Oh, my God. I don't even see it, and I'm looking for it. I'm sure people who are experts of this game. I'm sure there are people who are experts at this game who are going to watch this video and right now be like yelling at the screen like, it's over there! It's over there! But over where? Over where? Okay, well, maybe I'm looking at this wrong. No. I was thinking maybe the yellow, like, systems. No. Hey, wait a minute. No, that's what I was at. No, god damn it. There we go. J-U-N-A-E system. Mars. Okay, there's Sol. Alpha Centauri, Sirius, Tau Ceti, Omicron, Arandi, Bernard Star. These are systems, not planets. Teneris, Zion, Sirian, Gamma, Alpha Gamma, Alpha Cygni. Regulus, Scion, Alpha Canis, Alpha Majora, Omega Redani. I don't think it's here, you guys. I'm looking. I don't think it's here. Yeah, you might have heard of it, Odyssey. Maybe it's a system somewhere, but it might not be in this game. Okay, I'm getting closer to the monitor because, like, I got good glasses here. I got trifocals, you guys. So, At some zoom level, I should be able to frickin' see Junae. I mean, I found Nevola quickly enough earlier. Nope. This is almost comedy now, you guys. This is almost comedy, I swear to God. Yeah, you guys, I'm not seeing it. I'm serious. I'm not seeing it. I've gone from one corner of this map. Like 4 or 5 times now, and I'm not seeing it. Am I wrong? Jeremiah, are you kidding me? Have you listened to my videos? Because Stellaris, I'm going to be honest now, after playing several hours of it, it's a bare shell of a game with a pretty interface. That's what I think it is. Now, to be fair, Distant Worlds took two expansions for it to really click with me. But at the same time, Distant Worlds, I felt, was something confusing but solid from the get-go. This Stellaris, it doesn't feel solid to me. It doesn't. Like, it just, every time I play Stellaris, I'm thinking I could be playing Distant Worlds. Every time. Because there's things. Okay, we're on video 9 now. And I'm just like, oh God, I'm fed up. So fed up. I just get more and more bored. It's got some good ideas, but it needs more. It needs espionage. It needs trade, like freighters going back and forth. It needs more clear systems. Like, if someone it's not Europa Universalis in space at all. It's not Crusader Kings in space either at all. It's like it kind of wants to be Distant Worlds a little bit. There are events, sure, but they're like not overtly exciting. They're basically some text, and then you click a button, and then some more. It's just nothing. It's like, eh. Yeah, I think I'm being punked, you guys. I can't find this. Yeah, the mid game, and from what I understand, the late game. I haven't even bothered to get the late game. The early game is kind of fun, but that's also my favorite part of any 4X. Is the exploration and expansion discovery part. What Stellaris helped me realize about Distant Worlds, one of the reasons I love it so much, is because the exploration and discovery part never really ends. Even in the mid game, even in the late game, you still have exploration ships going out there and finding stuff. So that's the great thing about Distant Worlds. If you have not bought Distant Worlds yet, Jeremiah, that's the one you need. I hate to say that because it's not a bad game. It's just a boring game. Like, if someone held a gun to my head and said, you have to play a 4X right now, Distant Worlds, no question. It's also my desert. Distant Worlds is also my desert island game. So, I couldn't get into Gal Civ 2 either, Jeremiah. It felt fairly lacking in soul to me. But Stellaris, even more so. Okay, I think I'm done, you guys. Have you guys seen it on the stream? Like, can you read the... there's a delay, I know. But have you guys seen it on the stream? Because, I mean, I think the text is pretty readable. You know what, Eric? What bothers me about Stellaris is that part of me wonders if they, like, shoved it out the door expecting it to need expansions. Like, get everyone excited, give them the base product, and then they need to buy DLC. You know? That's what concerns me, because it feels very bare bones. Feels very bare bones. Yeah, I think I'm being punked, Odyssey, because I... Hey, honey.
Hello.
Can you help me with something?
Yeah.
Okay. I've been ordered... Come here. Hi, friends. I'm enlisting the aid of my girlfriend, Nicole. I don't know if you can hear her on this little headset mic.
Hello.
All right. So I've been ordered to find this system.
Well, you don't take orders from nobody.
I'm a loose cannon.
Sorry, was that not your question?
It's not my question.
Okay, go try again, try again.
I've been asked to go to this system, J-U-N-A, Jeune, is how I'm pronouncing it. How would you pronounce it?
That is so not French.
Jeune, just Jeune.
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 Or Junai?
Maybe. Anyway, so...
Junae.
Okay, so I've been going through the map here, trying to find it, and I can't. And so I was wondering, I'm going to just take you through a little tour of the map.
You want me to try to see it?
Yeah, I can't. I've gone through the map 6 times.
Maybe it stands for Jupiter, Uranus, Neptune, a planet not in our solar system.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. J, wait. J-U-N...
There's no
A, though.
I know.
There's no A, so that doesn't work.
A stands for a planet not in our solar system.
Oh, my God, that doesn't work. Okay, but yeah, there's no... I could not see... Let me know when you're ready to scroll.
Yeah, yeah.
So you scroll over here, and there's some more. And I couldn't see it here either. Let me know when you're ready to scroll.
Okay.
Okay, that's that. Let me know when you're ready to scroll.
Yeah. Kroger.
That's Kroger. That's the guy from The Highlander, I think.
Still no Junae.
Wait. There's one more little cluster over here.
Yeah, you must have broken it. It's not there.
How did I break it? Yeah, I'm not. You're, so.
I guess you can't play space games anymore. Everything.
Okay, guys. Space Game Junkie is shutting down. Effectively today. It's been great working with all of you. It's been great knowing you all. I'm retiring effective immediately from space gaming.
It's
the only thing that makes sense anymore. The site will be shut down. No, the site will stay up. I'll archive it. It'll be there forever. But yeah, I'm done with Space Game Junkie.
This is the last
straw. This is actually, Odyssey, you want to look for the CRPG Addict. That's actually the site, the blog that inspired me.
I missed a golden opportunity to pretend I saw it and point to a blank space on the map and try to convince you you were crazy. No!
I don't know if you heard that, guys, but my girlfriend said she missed an opportunity for her to totally mess with me by pointing at a blank spot on the map going, it's right there. Why don't you see it? Now, Odyssey, Space Game Junkie was inspired by a blog called the CRPG Addict. And that's what you want to go. That's kind of what Space Game Junkie is. It's obscure game junkie. But if I had all the time in the world, I would also start a naval game junkie and a flight sim junkie. I mean, I kind of have the Facebook groups, but, like, I'd want to make content. I like her too, Dan. Thank you. So, yeah, I think I'm done with this, you guys, because this is crazy. I love racing games, Odyssey. I'm just terrible at them. Absolutely terrible at them. But I love them. But I'm awful at them. Carmageddon is my type of racing game. No, not Train Sim Junkie. I can't afford the DLC. I don't have that kind of budget. I can't afford $2,000 or however much it is for one game. Dan, we have started Naval Game Junkie over on Facebook. We started the group Naval Game Junkie. We also have Flight Sim Junkie and Rogue Game Junkie. So those are all Facebook groups if you'd like to join us. But yeah, so June. I'm not going crazy. I'm not going crazy. The game asked me to go to a system that doesn't exist. Congratulations, trolls. First, you vote for Privateer 2, and I get so drunk I black out. Then you feel bad for me, and you vote for Off-World Trading Company. Then, the pity goes away, and you vote for this. I don't dislike this game, but it's got issues. I paid for this. I paid for the DLC that's supposed to give me all this content and all these features. And if I was just a regular gamer, I'd ask for a refund right now because how am I supposed to go to a system that doesn't exist, that doesn't make any sense? And it's a shame because I know the creator. I know the creator. I'm a friend of the creator. I like him. I like Derek. He's a great guy. I appreciate what he's trying to do. But when you run into a wall like this, you can't just help but throw your hands up and go, I'm done. You guys got an hour and 41 minutes out of me doing this. So I hope you are happy. Let's see. What is on the poll for next week? I will add that to the options, Dan. I always take suggestions for the poll for next week for this new thing because I want people to have their voices heard. So let's see. Besides, hang on a second. Let me just look at Trello here. I have everything on Trello. If you guys haven't used Trello, by the way, it's the most amazing thing. So X-Wing. Hang on, I'm just adding it to the list. All right. So in the options for next week's poll, and you guys are always free. If you go to spacegamejunkie.com, you can make more suggestions. But so far, the options for next week include Toxic, Avorion, Reunion, if you remember of Reunion, Star Control 3, Tachyon the Fringe, Starbound, and now X-Wing Alliance. So seven. So far, there are seven options for next week's poll, you guys. So next Thursday at 5:30 Pacific time, I'll be playing one of them, whichever one wins. Next week on the podcast, we are bringing back the developer of Ascent, the space game. We had him on a couple of years ago, and his game has since gone from browser to Steam to early access to out of early access. So we're bringing James back, the developer of Ascent, the space game, which is a great game, by the way, to talk to him next Tuesday at 5:30 Pacific. And then next Thursday, yeah, I know, Dan, there's always going to be at least one troll suggestion in here. And then next Thursday, I'll be playing one of these games. Also, the game for next week is Space Food Truck. We're going to be doing a Let's Play series for next week of Space Food Truck. So keep an eye out for that. If I have time this weekend, I'm not sure if I will, but if I have time, I might stream some more Elite Engineers beta. But yeah, I want to thank everyone for watching. I can't play Dark Souls Odyssey. I tried, and I wanted to shoot myself. I want to thank everyone for watching and basically being my support group through this. I really appreciate it. And I will see you all later. Have a great night and a great weekend. And I'll talk to you later.